Well, because a few weeks ago you had said yourself, look, you thought the stock was a little bit high, and it then fell about 10% after that. So do you still think the stock is a little high?
Well, it depends on how people, if somebody's a long-term holder of the stock, I think there's a lot of appreciation that will occur in the long term. In the short term, it's difficult to predict these fluctuations. But it does seem as though, for a company that had a few billion dollars in revenue last year, to have a $30+ billion market cap is on the high side. Mm-hmm. And I think that's, I think there's certainly lots of people on the internet who say that. And then,
So you still feel that way then about your stock?
I feel like it's always difficult to predict the short-term fluctuations. So if someone's a long-term holder of the stock, I don't think they should sell the stock. I think it will appreciate and ultimately be much higher than it is today. But in terms of short-term fluctuations, that's impossible to say.
Now, the press coverage of this event was sad. Sell your stock. I don't care. Do I think Tesla will be worth more than this in 5 years? I think the answer is yes.
So explain it for them then.
I'll try.
Okay.
But I'm also not trying to convince people that much. The results will speak for themselves. My premise is never to try to convince people why they should invest in Tesla. Sell your stock. I don't care. In order to transform energy and transport, you have to make an ungodly, gargantuan amount of battery cells. There have been hundreds of car company startups over the years, hundreds. And yet the only companies that have not gone bankrupt are Ford and Tesla. I think some critical mass of the market has concluded that Tesla will win, I guess. I mean, I've gone on record already as saying I think the stock price is a bit high. That was well before its current level. So, but if you ask me, like, do I think Tesla will be worth more than this in 5 years? I think the answer is yes. And by the way, I mean, honestly, I feel a bit bad about hating on the oil and gas industry, but I can just honestly speak on their behalf for a second here.
All right.
I mean, for a lot of the people in the oil and gas industry, especially if they're on the older side, they kind of built their companies and did their work before it was clear that this was a serious issue. Mm-hmm. And now they feel probably kind of hard done by that, like, people are making them out to be villains when they're for the longest time just working hard to support the economy and didn't really know that it was going to be all that bad.